A recent viewer sent me an email and asked, I proposed to my fiance yesterday and she's already planning details of the wedding with her family. Is there anything I'm supposed to do? That is a great question. So let's take a look at a groom's guide to wedding planning. What's up, Manly Bands Nation? I have got some good news for you. Not every bride is a bridezilla, and not every groom is indifferent to his wedding ceremony. In fact, some men are actually better at planning big events than their other halves. So how do you navigate the roles of wedding planning without stepping on each other's toes? The first step is to communicate with each other. Having a straightforward discussion on who is in charge of what will make the entire process so much easier. There's this idea of the 80-20 rule, where 80% of your expenses come from 20% of your decisions. So you two need to decide what that perfect 20% is. The big three of wedding planning are the guest list, date, and menu. Both you and your bride-to-be should decide on who to invite and who not to invite to your wedding. You should rank friends according to their importance, just in case you need to limit your guest list. When picking your date, make sure the wedding doesn't coincide with major holidays, sporting events, or family traditions that may cause your guests not to attend. When it comes to catering, you'll need to decide if you'll be serving simple finger foods or will it be a formal affair with all the fixins. The venue takes up most of the costs. Always ask if you can bring your own spirits, use your own caterer, and how they handle cleaning up and packing up wedding gifts at the venue. Now it's time to choose your best man and groomsmen. You might fill your roster with your best friends, men in your family, or your bride-to-be's favorite weird brother, Steve. These men will act as your team members. They're your go-to sources for wedding planning ideas, running errands, giving advice, and literally keeping you sane. I'll go over how to pick your best man and groomsmen later on. Music is a huge part of any celebration, especially at your wedding. And the music can tell a lot about your personality as a couple, especially if you choose Can't Help Falling in Love With You, because nobody's ever thought of that one before. When you're planning your wedding, make sure to give the DJ a must-play and a do-not-play list, depending on the tastes and styles of you and your bride. Make sure the DJ understands your style preference. If you're both into synth pop music, it's a good idea to give your DJ a heads up. A wedding registry may not sound like something you'd be into, but it can be a lot of fun and be set up as a fun date activity. Most online and physical stores have wedding registries where a couple can pick out items that they would love to have as gifts for their new home. Help your guests know what you're into by getting this list started early. Otherwise, just expect a wall of towels and toasters. Next, start writing your wedding vows. To get started, follow the three F's: forever, fidelity, and falling in love. Write about forever, how long you want your love and marriage to last. Express your fidelity, your promise and commitment to her as her husband. And keep telling her that you are falling in love. You did it before and you like to do it over and over again. Now, here's something only you can do. It's time to make sure you're the healthiest version of yourself. This might mean eating healthier, going to the gym, or breaking bad habits. You're gonna be all dressed up, looking super handsome in those photos. So make sure this is a time in your life where you can be like, damn, I wanna stay this way forever. And when you're ready to find the right tux, here's a few tips. Get a good tailor. A proper fit makes a huge impact. Go for timeless over trendy. You're going to be reminiscing over these photos for a long time. Skip the cummerbund. Come on, this isn't your high school prom. Decide between a bow tie or a straight tie. One of the most fun things you're going to be doing is planning your honeymoon. You should take the lead on this one. Planning your honeymoon is a lot easier than planning the wedding itself. Since you're only planning a trip for two, I recommend chatting with your fiance about a few places you both have dreamed of visiting. If you're able, plan for at least 1 week on the honeymoon and use this time to make some incredible memories. And finally, buy the gifts for your groomsmen. This is customary for the groom, so don't mess this up. We have several badass gifts that would be perfect for your team. Being helpful in the wedding planning process is usually appreciated, but you also need to stay in your lane. Steer clear of the bridesy stuff she may want to deal with herself, such as her wedding dress, the wedding invitations, bridesmaids' dresses, wedding flowers, and the wedding cake. You'll be needed for the tasting, but the final decision will still be hers. Keep in mind, your future bride-to-be may have been planning this day for years, but she can still get stressed. So here's a few things you can do to help her feel more at ease. Keep dating during the wedding planning phase. Take her to dinner, bring her flowers, or book a couple's massage. Practice your first dance together as a couple. This romantic moment will go a long way. Be a buffer between your love and anyone that interferes in the wedding prep, causing her stress. Now, earlier, I mentioned how important it is to pick the right groomsmen and best man. It's so important, I actually made a video about it right here. And if you just pop the question, first off, congratulations. But if you're still trying to figure out how to announce it to everybody, well, I got you, because I made a video about it right here. Your wedding day is a special moment between you and your partner, so don't let the stress of planning the big day get in the way of the happiest day of your life. Well, good luck to you. Till next time, Archie out. Oh, look at that. He didn't fall off.